Hey everyone, welcome back to Game Dev Box. It's Aryan here and I'm so excited to have you with me today. I have a video about the trajectory but for 2D purposes. So I told myself to change those scripts to work on a 3D world, and this is the result. This approach is for beginners and ensures a smooth understanding of the code. So follow me to show you step by step how it is implemented. I have set up 2 cameras, one orthographic and one perspective, to demonstrate that the trajectory works in both scenarios. Some solutions may only work in perspective mode, having both is an advantage. In the scene, I have included a directional light and environment with walls and ground, and several ball game objects. Each ball has a sphere collider with a physics material and a default rigid body. Additionally, each ball has a script called ball. Let's explore the contents of the ball script. The ball script is simple. It initializes the rigid body, called RB, and provides a property pose for easy access to the object's position. The push method is public and can be called from other scripts. It takes a vector 3 parameter named force and applies an impulse force to the rigid body using add force. The force applied is based on the input force parameter and is applied in force mode dot impulse. Then in hierarchy, we have the level manager object, which has a level manager script and trajectory script. Let's first disable the trajectory and see the code in level manager. In the properties section, we capture the camera, push force, and the layer for our balls. Next, we introduce the default ball, which is an instance of the ball script. Additionally, we have variables such as isDragging, start point, as a vector 3 for calculating the clicked position, endpoint, direction, force, and distance, all of which are important for our calculations. At the start, we obtain the camera reference. In the update loop, we take the mouse position as a ray, which returns a ray projected from the camera through a screen point. If a left click occurs, we perform another conditional check to action a raycast. The raycast uses the obtained ray as the first parameter and then out raycast hit for storing the result data. We set the maximum distance to infinity, specify that we want to interact only with the ball layer, and assign the ball layer dot value to layer parameters. Additionally, we set the query trigger interaction to collide. If our ray hits an object with the ball layer that has a collider, we set the time scale to 0.1 for slow motion effects, and we set the is dragging to true and assign the default ball to the ball that was hit. We call the onDragStart function, which simply stores the mouse position in the start point variable. Now that isDragging is true, we check in the update loop. If true, we call the onDrag function, which continuously stores the mouse position for each frame into the endpoint, calculates the distance and direction, multiplies them by push force, and stores the result in the force variable. In the update loop, we check if the left click is released. If so, we set the time scale back to 1 and is dragging to false. Following this, we call onDragN function, which essentially invokes the push method from the ball script, passing the calculated force as its parameter. Press the play button. Now we can drag the balls and apply force to push them. Now let's set up the trajectory. First, open the level manager and uncomment these lines. Here it gets the trajectory instance, and in onDragStart it calls the trajectory.show function. In onDrag there is a line where it calls the trajectory.update. With two arguments, the first being the ball's position and the second being the force. In the onDrag, the trajectory.height function is called. Drag the trajectory script into this section. I completely forgot to mention that you need to create a layer and assign that layer to balls or any game object you want to push, and then set that layer in here. Now let's explore the trajectory script. The dots number is serialized field, setting the desired number of dots to display when pushing. We have a game object dots parent to store the instantiated game objects. The dots prefab is the prefab we want to instantiate. There are also variables for the spacing between dots and the scale range between the minimum and maximum values. This allows our dots to be larger near the ball and smaller near the ground. We have dots list, position and flow timestamp variables. In the start function we call height and prepare dots function. Regarding height and show, the show function sets dots parent to be active, while the height function does the opposite. The prepare dots function runs only once. It instantiates the dots and scales each one accordingly. Initially all dots scales are set to the maximum. We also calculate a scale factor as the maximum scale divided by dots number. Then in a for loop we instantiate the dots, set their parents to dots parent, and at the end we set the dot scales to the scale variable. We also check if the scale is bigger than the minimum scale, and if so we decrease the value. We had update dots in onDrag. This function stores the space dots in a timestamp. It then calculates the x and z positions of dots in each frame based on the applied force, multiply the timestamp, plus the current dot position. For the y position, it is same but uses the gravity values to decrease the y position in each frame. We set the position of each dot and repeat the process for the following dots. I have set the number of dots to 25. For dots parent, I have created an empty game object. As for the dots prefab, I have used a simple sphere with no additional elements. It's just a sphere. The dot spacing is set to 0.1. The minimum scale for dots is 0.01 and the maximum scale is 0.25. That's all for the setup. Now let's press the play button and you will see that the trajectory is drawn without any issue. It works great. Let's check the perspective camera. You have the flexibility to customize the dots as you wish. For example, let's give them a simple cube. Alternatively, you can change the balls to any game object of your preference. I have included the project link in the description. Thanks for watching. Feel free to follow Game Dev Box for more tutorials and tips. Don't forget to hit the like button. See you next time.